First of all, thank all of you for being here this morning. This afternoon. We want to talk about the officer-involved shooting that occurred this morning. At 9:08 this morning, a Shelby County deputy sheriff conducted a traffic stop at the 4,000 block of Rosswood Drive. At some point during the traffic stop, the suspect attempted to leave the scene, and the deputy tried to stop the suspect from leaving and was dragged by the suspect's vehicle for approximately 100 yards. During the confrontation inside the vehicle, the deputy fired a shot, striking the suspect. The suspect then crashed his vehicle into a parked car in the 4700 block of Allendale. He was transported to the hospital where the suspect was pronounced deceased. As per our protocol, the district attorney's office was contacted, as well as TBI. And special agents from TBI are investigating the incident. The deputy is at Region 1 in critical but stable condition, and we are expecting him to undergo surgery sometime tonight. Our prayers go out to the officer. This is another tragic and sad example of the violence against our law enforcement officers and citizens that have become all too common in our community. We will keep you updated on the officer's condition and ask for the community's prayers. And to the citizen who helped assist the injured deputy, I say to you, sir, thank you, and you represent the best of our community. Thank you. I'll answer any questions that might come in.
Sir, can you talk a little bit about the traffic enforcement that was going on in that neighborhood
which led up to the stop? Right. Well, that's under the investigation with TBI. They're going back, and I did not mention there was body cam footage. There's not only body cam footage, but there's also footage from the officer's vehicle as well. Well, we're going to let TBI make the identifications for all.
Did the suspect get back into the vehicle and drive away after he was shot?
That's correct. No, not before he was shot. He was taken out of the vehicle during the traffic stop. He and the deputy were outside the vehicle. Then the suspect got back in the vehicle, and that's when all the... He hit another vehicle at the 4700 block of Allendale. This was once the deputy had been dragged for 100 yards, and then he went on. A shot was fired. Then he went on to the 4700 block of Allendale is where he crashed. Yes, dragged by the vehicle. The deputy was inside the car when the driver of the vehicle took off, and the deputy was dragged for approximately 100 yards.
Is that where most of the deputy's injuries took place?
No, he has more serious injuries than just road rash, what we would call road rash. No, he has more serious injuries than that.
Was the deputy shot as well?
No, sir.
Just for clarity, what's the deputy?
We're not for sure what happened and how that traffic stop went to that point. We do know that the deputy and the driver of the vehicle were outside of the vehicle. The driver then went back, and the deputies tried to stop him from leaving the scene. And the driver took off, and the deputy was trapped between the car and the door. You know, the door was still open.
Accepted.
Well, TBI, you know, it will be an investigation. TBI is the lead agency on the investigation. Certainly, we're cooperating fully with TBI. They will have access to body cams as well as the mobile vehicle video as well, in-car video. So, you know, they'll have it. And then eventually it will go to the DA's office for their review.
Sheriff, talk a little bit more about, you described this as a tragedy, the LDA's line of things are concerned about the crime, and you know how it's impacting law enforcement. What's the message to the inmates who are concerned tonight about incidents like this one?
Well, you know, one of the things that I really want to focus on is the good citizen, the citizen that saw that officer that was out laying in the middle of the street and picked up his radio, the officer's radio, and called for help. That citizen, we didn't know at the time that the officer was injured. He took upon himself to take the officer's radio and call the dispatcher and tell the dispatcher what was going on, and it just represents the best of our community. Crime is unacceptable here in Memphis now, and we're doing all that we can do, and it's just a tragedy that this had to happen to the officer, to the suspect, and you know, we're hoping that the officer recovers full, make a full recovery, but this is what's going on in our community now. I'm sorry, repeat your question.
Was the suspect just parked on the street? Did he live there? Do you know anything about that?
No, it was a traffic stop.
Okay.
That's what the initial...
What the initial cause of the traffic stop?
No, sir, we don't. That's still being investigated by TBI.
When you say the officer or the deputy was driving by this building, was looking at the door, or how did that...
That's still being investigated by TBI. The officer will... they'll have all that information for you later, I'm sure. Okay?
How many shots were fired? Just the one?
One shot. One shot was fired.
Hey, guys, yes. We have to get back to the hospital. As the
yes, we're on the way.
There'll be some updates coming yep. About the condition of the officer.
Okay. It was the traffic stop was at the 4100 block of Rosswood Drive. Okay? All right, thank y'all. Thank you.